30 minutes past the hour right now. Scenes of devastation repeating themselves across Haiti. We've seen building after building pancaked into piles of rubble, trapping and killing people inside. And as the number of dead climbs to 70,000 and could ultimately, by some estimates, there hit 200,000 or more, most building experts agree that the toll wouldn't be so high if they were better built. Joining us now to talk more about this, as well as Haiti's future rebuilding, John Mutter, professor at Columbia University's Earth Institute. Thanks for being with us this morning, John.
You're welcome. Thank you.
In a Time magazine piece, you said, quote, earthquakes don't kill people, bad buildings kill them. Scientifically speaking, was this disaster preventable?
Certainly not the earthquake itself.
A lot is the poorest country in the Western Hemisphere. It's one of the poorest countries in the world. And the building materials, the building codes, I mean, many people say they're just non-existent in terms of adhering to what we saw in these situations. You talk about how many of these were handmade in people's homes. There's not really any type of systematic, design to them. And it's just sort of what you get is what you get. But moving forward, I mean, we've seen this outpouring of aid. Obviously, we're dealing with the immediacy, easier said than done in these types of situations. I mean, even if you do rebuild, where are the jobs and the struggle with the deforestation? I mean, that's one of the issues. Where's the renewable energy? Where is, I guess, the future for a country that is so devastated? How do you start?
Oh, it's a terrible problem. Development
in some of the reading and research that we've been doing over the past week in the wake of this disaster, they say by some estimates Haiti has more NGOs, non-governmental organizations,
so
on the ground than any other country.
Right.
Yet, you know, there's so many varying organizations sort of piecemealing it, and not to disparage what they're doing because they're trying to help an immensely poor nation. But is there some sort of future organizational structure where this can be done on a mass level in a way that helps fuel the economy of Haiti?
Yes, build.
Before we leave, I thought this was really interesting. Mercy Corps, this relief organization, was talking about what they did in the wake of the Bande Aceh after the tsunami there.
Yeah.
And they basically paid people a daily wage to clear debris, to restore buildings, and to instill sort of a sense of some sort of self-control over what's going on. Is that something that is feasible in Haiti?
Let's hope so. I mean, if you just...
This morning, and you can read more of John Mutter's commentary. It is on our website, cnn.com/amfix. Thanks for being with us this morning.
Thank you.
John?
The plight of...